There's honey in the rock, water in the stone, manna on the ground, no matter where I go. I don't need to worry now that I know everything I need, you've got. There's honey in the rock.
Praying for a miracle, thirsty for the living well. Only you can satisfy. Sweetness at the mercy seat. Now I've tasted, it's not hard to see that only you can satisfy.
There's honey in the rock. 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 Where the Spirit is, bounty in the wilderness, you will always satisfy. There's honey in the rock, water in the stone, manna on the ground, no matter where I go. I don't need to worry now that I know everything I need, you've got. There's honey in the rock and purpose in your plan. Power in the blood and healing in your hand. Started flowing when you said it is done. Everything you did's enough. I keep looking, I keep finding. You keep giving, keep providing. I have all that I need. You are all that I need. I keep praying, you keep moving. I keep praising, you keep proving. I have all that I need. You are all that I need. I keep looking, I keep finding. You keep giving, keep providing. I have all that I need. You are all that I need. I keep praying, you keep moving. I keep praising, you keep proving. I have all that I need. You are all that I need. I have all that I need. You are all that I need. Yeah. There's honey in the rock, water in the stone, manna on the ground, no matter where I go. I don't need to worry now that I know everything I need, you've got. There's honey in the rock and purpose in your plan. Power in the blood and healing in your hand. Started flowing when you said it is done. Jesus, who you are, is enough. There's honey in the rock. There's honey in the rock. There's honey in the rock.
And oh, how sweet it is to trust in you, Jesus. Oh, how sweet it is to trust in you, Jesus. Oh, how sweet it is to trust in you. Sing these songs as I always. often do, but every song I stand, and you never do. So I throw all that I have is a hallelujah, hallelujah. And I know it's not much, but I'm nothing else fit for a king, except for a heart singing hallelujah. I've got just one move, with my arms stretched wide, I'll worship you. So I throw up my hands and praise you again and again, 'cause all that So come on, my soul, oh, don't you get shy on me. Lift up your song, 'cause you've got a lion inside of those lungs. Get up and praise the Lord. Oh, so come on, my soul, oh, don't you get shy on me. Lift up your song. You got a lion inside of those lungs. Get up and praise the Lord. Oh, 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 oh. Come on, my soul. Oh, don't you get shy on me. Lift up your song. 'Cause you've got a lion. Oh, don't you get shy on me, lift up your song, 'cause you've got a lion inside of those lungs. Oh, get up and praise, oh, get up and praise the Lord. So I throw up my hands and praise you again and again, 'cause all that I have is a heart. Hallelujah.
Silent night, holy night, all is calm, all is bright, round yon virgin mother and child, holy infant so tender and mild, sleep in heavenly peace, sleep in heavenly peace. Ooh. Ooh. Silent night, holy night, shepherds quake at the sight, glory stream from heaven afar, heavenly hosts sing alleluia, Christ the Savior is born, Christ the Savior is born.
Christmas Believers Church from me and my sweet bride. We hope you are having a wonderful Christmas morning. Thank you for hanging out with us this morning. I know you enjoyed Michael and Olivia leading you in a little worship and a Christmas tune. It's always good, and it's very touching and moving, at least to us, and I trust to you as well. Again, Merry Christmas. Robin and I just want to say thank you so much for hanging out with us this morning. We're in our sanctuary, all empty, but you're in our heart, because we wanted to give you a chance on Christmas morning to spend time with your family, spend time with the kids, enjoy one another, because we believe building family is very important.
Absolutely. So thanks for taking just a minute out of your morning. I know it's so important. Just a minute out of your morning to join us online. So it's great to have family that just reaches across even the four walls. It's great to have technology that we can come into people's homes and be with them. So we are excited. We're excited to spend this moment with you. There is so much to unpack in the Christmas story. Mark is getting ready to read it in just a minute. But as we've been thinking about it, and I've been just pondering Christmas and getting ready for the season, the thing that I love the most about the story of Jesus is it was so much more than just the moment of his birth. I know that that is really what we celebrate when we think about Christmas Day, but there's so much more to unpack. So when he gets ready to read this morning, I just want to challenge you to maybe think about a little bit more than just the virgin birth or the baby that was swaddled in the manger, and just the acts of that day, the things that happened on the particular day that he was born. Because the truth of the matter is that Jesus coming to the planet, bringing us salvation, was about a much bigger and broader picture. We've been talking a lot in just on our Sunday morning sermons, we've been talking a lot about time and about the God of eternity past and an eternity future. Sometimes we can miss the moment, not really understanding the broader perspective. So I don't want you to miss the moment today. When he's reading the story, I want you to understand that everything about the God of the past showed up that day, and he set everything in motion to be eradicated, that needed to be eradicated. And he put into motion the things for our future that would be so beneficial for us, that we wouldn't have to live according to the law and according to legalism. And the same thing, you know, applies to us. I know sometimes we read the story like it was so many thousands of years ago, but the Bible says that salvation is now. Mm-hmm. And the Bible says that He has given us everything we need for life and godliness here on this planet. And I believe that that is what happened that day, that He covered our past and He made a way for our future. So I don't know what this year has looked like for you. I don't know the challenges that you've faced in your family or your finances or just maybe in your heart with God, just your relationship. All of those things are covered by the blood of Jesus, and He made a way to call you to a higher spot tomorrow. Yeah. So, which is really what He was doing. He called us to a place where we have relationship with Him, and He could work and weave and make His way into our life. So I love that about Christmas. This day is great to be celebrated. Always. I love it. I'm at home with my kids, just mm-hmm. like you are this morning, and we're having a wonderful morning with hot chocolate and breakfast and cinnamon rolls and the stories and you know, and Jesus and all the songs. But I'm excited because I know that what He gave me on this day is for the very rest of my life. So it affects every moment from here on out. So that's so exciting for me.
One of the things that we do that we want to share and maybe pass on to you, I'm sure everybody has traditions, right? Every family has traditions. One of ours is we sleep in a tent for like 2 weeks, all the kids,
like
the dogs, the babies, everybody, even your mother, like everybody sleeps in a tent. We've got a lot of traditions we do. We do a pajamas on last night. We do pajamas every Christmas. But the thing that we do that I always like is we get, when our families get together, we always ask either your dad or my dad, the grandfathers, to pray blessings, and then one of them typically will read the story.
Absolutely.
So we want to do that for you this morning. I'm going to read the Christmas story. I'm sure you know it. Like Robin said, the story is 2,000 years old, but the life of Jesus and the Holy Spirit is fresh every single day. Absolutely. We're excited about next year, what God's going to be doing, but we're even more blessed that we're ending the year with you. If you've made this your home this year and you've kind of come on the corner with us to worship, thank you so much. I know it's been an honor for me and for Robin to be your shepherds, to pastor you, to teach the Bible, to encourage you. And we want to call you higher this year. We want to call you higher in your life with God, in your families. So as I read the Christmas story, that's all I'm going to do, just going to read it. I want you to let the words soak into your heart. Maybe get the kids around or the family for a moment, and we're going to read the story together. And then at the end of the story, I'm just going to pray the blessing like my dad does or like Robin's dad. I'm going to pray a blessing over you. We're going to start this day with a blessing, and we're going to believe that God touches you in a supernatural way. Luke chapter 2, verse 1 through verse 21. In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria, and everyone went to their own town to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him, and she was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger because there was no guest room available for them. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior is born to you, and He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find the baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great company of heavenly hosts appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heavens and on earth, peace to those on whom His favor rests." And when the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the manger. And when they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. But Mary treasured all these things and pondered them in her heart. And the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all things they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told. And on the eighth day, when it was time to circumcise the child, he was named Jesus, the name the angel had given him before he was conceived. As I get ready to pray a blessing over you, and Robin and I agree of what God's going to do in your life, think about this today. Oftentimes we think about, like Robin said, Mary, Joseph, a pregnant lady, no room in the inn, the story, the animals, the manger, the shepherds. But I love one thing about this story that always touches me. The shepherds were the very first people at the birth of Jesus Christ that heralded the 50 feet of their life. They left that manger and they owned their 50 feet. That's what I ask you to do today. Don't just open presents and sing the songs and watch all the shows and the movies and eat the waffles and the eggs and all the things we have planned. Today's a great day to own your 50 feet. Call a friend, reach out to a neighbor, bless each other, pray over each other. You never know who needs to know about the God in the highest. You never know who needs peace. You never know who needs joy. But when you own your 50 feet, God can bring it in the right time. So would you do me a favor? Maybe gather everybody around, husband, wife, grab hands with each other. Kids are around, gather them all around. Hey, if you're by yourself today, maybe family hasn't gathered yet, why don't you just put your hand over your heart? I'm going to pray a blessing over you and believe that God stirs your life for great things to come. So Heavenly Father, today, Robin and I thank you so much for a wonderful group of people that we have been asked to shepherd and to lead. And God, as pastors of this house and as the leaders of this flock, I pray a blessing over everybody that calls believers home. I bless you today with life. I bless you with peace. I bless you that any sorrow that is facing you now would pale in comparison to the peace and the joy of the Holy Spirit. I bless you that there shall be smiles on your face, songs in your heart, that your thoughts shall be thoughts of prosperity and blessing. I bless you with health from your head to your toes. I bless you that all your needs will be met. I bless you as you end this year and approach next year. No weapon formed against you will prosper. God will expand your life. Your tent pegs will expand, and your life, your children, your family, husbands, wives, I call you to the blessings of the Lord. The blessings of the Lord that make rich and add no sorrow. The blessing of the Lord that have no regret to them. Now, Father, I thank you by the Holy Spirit, Robin and I today, every person that's worshiped with us this morning and sang with us, every person that's heard the reading of the word, I bless them now. I bless all the kids today as we celebrate the birth of Jesus Christ, as we honor this day for the Savior of the world, who died for us and lives for us, forgave us of our sins, and in the strangest of way now calls us his own. We do believe in Jesus today. I want to lead you in a prayer. It's a short prayer this morning. Would you just all pray this after me? Heavenly Father, this day I make Jesus Christ the Lord of my life. I thank you for sending him to die for me, but to also live for me. I call him my Lord and my Savior. Thank you, Jesus, for your life. Amen. Robin and I love you today. Thank you so much for hanging out with us. And right now, we have a very special video from our B Kids at Believers Church.
The sunset, I sweep the snow from my doorstep. I just can't help but stop and grin. It's like I'm 10 years old again. And everywhere I go, I can feel it. Some say it moves like a spirit that falls on us once a year, like it came on a midnight clear. The soul of this season is a gift. When love came down to let us live,
Let's open up and let our hearts embrace this moment.
For Christmas this year, we're gonna make a sound, gonna make it loud. For Christmas this year, we're gonna make some noise, let the world rejoice. For Christmas this year, for Christmas, for Christmas this year.
And the laughter starts before the sunrise. I sneak downstairs to sparkling eyes, and oh, what joy it brings to me.
Up and up and